thank you so much to everyone who tuned into our first ever live stream on World Ballet Day. Make sure to join us for the opening of our 2016-2017 season with the wonderful classic ballet Giselle, beginning October 21st.
Welcome to Miami City Ballet. My name is Michael Breeden.
And I'm Rebecca King, and we are dancers here at Miami City Ballet, and we are also the hosts of a podcast called Conversations on Dance, which you can find on iTunes. We are so happy to be a part of World Ballet Day, a 20-hour global live stream on Facebook Live. Today we're thrilled to give you a peek inside our studios as we rehearse George Balanchine's Divertimento No. 15. We will be performing Divert, as we call it, in South Florida, this April, as part of our program four.
Divert is a work that was choreographed in 1956 by George Balanchine, one of the greatest 20th century choreographers. And though Balanchine is famous for pioneering neoclassicism in ballet with seminal works like Agon and Apollo, today we'll find him working in his purest classical form, as inspired by the music of Mozart.
So structurally, this ballet is made up of 8 core women, 5 principal women, and 3 principal men. Each of the 5 principal women have their own variation, as well as a pas de deux. So today we will be looking at 2 of those variations.
And though, as is often the case with Balanchine works, you can see the imprint of its originators, you will also find that there's plenty of room for our dancers to bring their special qualities to this work.
So today, first we will be getting a look at our soloist, Jordan Elizabeth Long, working with artistic director Lourdes Lopez on the second variation. Afterwards, we'll be able to have a chance to sit down and talk with Jordan. So if you have any questions that you'd like to ask her, click over to our Facebook page at facebook.com/Miami City Ballet, and we'll get to as many questions as we can.
So let's go have a look.
Okay, Jordan. So remember, it's Balanchine and Mozart, so it's classicism at its best. And the whole ballet is really about showing the classical steps. It's about showing quasi, it's about showing en face, it's about showing efface attitude. So they're all classical positions that you know the entire variation. So why don't we break it apart a little bit, do the first section, and then we'll come back. How's that? Now already, real quasi-head, right? You're this way. That, there we go. Okay. Okay, nice. Okay, very nice. And you got your ceases in. This is fine. You're going to start here, right? You're going to face your audience. You're going to do so. This is completely en face. You want to travel a little bit more this way. You want to step a little bit more that way. And this, you have to turn your whole body so you're quasi. So there's a lot more movement in that whole beginning. Do that without the music. And 1, 2, 3, travel, step over, bum, ba, arabesque, plie, bum, 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 travel. There you go, very nice, right, excellent. Now this has to have a quality of down, right, with a little bit of a jazzy hip, and then it's the second leg. So down, and second leg, and down, and second leg, and down, and second leg. Right, okay, you wanna go from the beginning again? Yeah.
Now remember, real quasi, and then you're gonna play en face to your audience. Travel, arabesque, please. Travel, there you go, right, nice. Down, second leg. Go on. Now arm to your audience, to your audience. All right, stop. Nice, very nice. Jordan, remember this is too much to the side. This, your échappée, this should be this way to that audience. Right, échappée that to that audience, and this way a lot more. Let me see that. Nice, nice wide échappée. Yes,
And move slowly arms, but sharp legs. Better. Now here, this was very good. This is quasi, but we have to see both those, that hitch kick happen in front. It can't be 1-2. It has to be an arabesque. So you're showing those legs to the audience. There you go. Nice. Very nice. Where do you want to go from? Anjitwa. Okay. Can we take it from there? And you want to try to move back a little bit. I know it's hard. Move back a lot more because this step happens in the center. Just a little bit back, Gabe. We have to go further back. So right where you started. So strong legs and soft arms. Bum, bum. That's okay, take from here. No, okay, start from the beginning. Just play from the beginning, but you can mark it. Now this is down, second leg. And now do this. Now show me those legs. Nice. When this was very good, so you finish here, right? You want to go up, and this you have to bend, right? And very important, you want to turn this leg out and PK. Turn it out and then bend. You see what happens there? Very nice. Right, do it one more time slowly without the music. It's a little fast with this tape. It's usually a little slower, but you want to get all that technique in. And arabesque and bend, bend and turn out, yes, and arabesque, bend and turn out and step out, nice. Jordan, can you see what happened to your circle?
Yeah.
It got huge. Now, your next step, remember what we spoke about? This is not so high, this is what your legs do. You're showing the audience the beauty of what a rond de jambe is and what it can look like. Yeah, and you show your leg off, and then you bend. There you go. Right. Gabe, do you have that the circle? Go back. Yeah, you can work a little bit further. So take your time. Take your time. Now take your time. Turn out, bend, turn out, yes. Now show me the leg, show it, yes, show it to the audience. I'm not even going to make you do that again. That was great. Great. Good. Yeah, you want to be careful. Very, very good. I think if you can, your last diagonal should travel a little bit more.
Okay.
So you have to, from that turn, step out because you're in one corner and you should really finish at the very end.
Okay.
And you want to land and then you want to pick. I know it's hard. Travel on that. I know you've heard this before. Up and... You want to do susu, you want to plie on your front leg. so that you're using your back leg to make that movement happen. Stay on the front leg. Bum, 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 bum. Excellent. All right. Do you think you can do the whole thing from beginning?
Okay.
Are you sure? Okay. All right, take a deep breath. So just listen to the music and just try to remember a few of the things that we spoke about, all right? Just show those positions of classical ballet that you know. Show those legs. Show those legs. Show the leg to the audience. Got yourself a variation. That's great. Thank you. Thank you. Good. Here we'll talk about a couple of things. Drew, that was very good.
So if you're just joining us, we are here at Miami City Ballet Studios rehearsing George Balanchine's Diverto Mento number 15 for World Ballet Day on Facebook Live. So we have a few questions from Facebook that we're going to have Jordan answer as soon as she comes over and joins us. Jordan?
We're ready for you.
That was beautiful. So fun to watch. So we have one question from Pamela, and she wonders what your favorite roles are and why.
My favorite role by far is the one I danced at Lincoln Center last year, which is the first movement principal in Bore Fantasque. Really often tall girls don't get to be funny, and in that one you do. So that's why it's my favorite.
And you were really great in that, and we really enjoyed watching you do it. You're so out of breath. I'm so sorry. You were great.
No, I think it's something worth mentioning is that that role that you danced Bore is originated by Tanigale Leclerc, who also originated this role. So Jordan is a natural in these sort of leggy moments. But obviously this role is not without challenges. You make it look so easy. It's very straightforward, simple classical ballet, but it's difficult. What are the biggest challenges you find in the variation?
The biggest challenge for me in this variation is the entrechassés at the very beginning. I'm really not good at entrechassés, but I've worked on it and I think it's a little better.
I was actually going to mention that because we've been working on it really hard, we know, and it looks so beautiful. It's really awesome. It's so great to see. So we have another question from Brennan. The question is, what's the difference from rehearsing on stage as in the studio?
I guess she means performing on stage. And that is that you kind of just put all your work in the studio, and then when you get on stage, you don't really have to worry so much, and you enjoy it more.
So this is your third season coming up at Miami City Ballet. What actually drew you to the company in the first place?
The season before I was coming to audition here, Lourdes was bringing the ballet Jardin Cat, and I thought, oh wow, this director is really bringing a great variety of repertoire to this company. And so that was what inspired me to come audition. And now that I'm here, I just love the people.
I was going to ask what makes you want to stay in this company and continue your career here and work so beautifully, because this is a little bit different from your upbringing, right? You were trained a little more classically. So at being in a balancing company like this, what is it that you find different and challenging, and what is it that's exciting for you and makes you want to be here?
I love the speed of balancing ballets. It's a big challenge for me because I'm long, hence my name. But I like having a challenge, and I also like the musicality and the way the Miami City Ballet dancers dance so much with music.
That's true, it is really good.
So what ballets are you looking forward to most coming up in this season?
Well, Divert, I feel like it's going to bring me to, it's kind of like I've learned something from the Balanchine training now and I can show it. And then also I'm going to do the role of Mirta in Giselle, and that's a really special role to me. So.
Something you've performed before, right? So what is it about this time that you expect to be a little different? Maybe just some time has passed, you've been able to work on it in a different way, you're a little older, more mature. What is it that makes revisiting roles like this really special for you?
Well, the whole ballet is Giselle, I think you can relate to more as you get older. But then from a technical aspect, I do think the Balanchine style classes have helped me with my jump a lot. And so I'm hoping to not get as tired this time that I do Mirta.
Well, it looks like our next dancer is almost ready. We will be seeing soloist Lauren Fadeley as coached by artistic director Lourdes Lopez in the fourth variation from Divert. Thanks for joining us, Jordan.
So, how do you want to start? Want to do little sections and then we'll go? Cut you short. Okay, good, good, Lauren. No. Now it's Tanicular Claire's variation. So it's about showing the legs, and also she had a lot of kind of humor and French wit. So it's not like you want to be a poster child, right, or poster girl, but you really want to show this, right? You want to show this, right? Exactly. And then you want to show that, and then it's show the legs. Right, so it's not here, it's here. Yeah, yes, it's all the way up, and then step straight to your audience, double, and you wanna finish you wanna hold the attitude just for a brief second. Do that without music. And, bumpa, show the leg, yes, show the leg, bumpa, show attitudes. Yeah, nice, you have to hold your stomach to stop yourself. Now hold your stomach, stop. There you go, same thing. And then here, when you do your rond de jambes, you have to stay onto your left side because this should happen with the upper body, right? So you can't be straight, it's this. So you wanna stay left, 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 left. All right, wanna do that with music? So very straightforward, just to show and show. Yes. Now left, left. All right, hold on, Gabe, thank you. So you wanna do a center, right, and you wanna lean this way as travel forward. Now here, you're almost, it's not really a ponche, but you're leaning back that way. And you wanna step back. So you don't want to bring that leg in. You want to keep that leg out. Low, right, to your passe, attitude, and then arabesque. And that whole thing travels forward. And you can be kind of very classical, right? Bump, 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 because that's what the ballet is, it's classicism. So you can kind of hold yourself there a little bit. Do that part without music. And step, bump, bump. Bum, bum, bum. No, you see how you brought that leg in and so you don't travel. From here, just fall back onto it. Bum, 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 bum. Yes, that travel back. So you want to plie on your weight, and when you releve, you have to go back. Plie on your weight. Plie on your leg. That plie and go back on the releve. Go back. Go back. Right. The old Dubrovska classes. Right. You plie and then the releve, you travel back. How are you feeling? Okay? Mm-hmm. You want to do that from the beginning and we'll add the développés?
Sure.
Okay. This was great, by the way. Yes, Lauren. Now left. travel, pied, travel, knives. Now legs and arm. Good. Better, right? You can still travel back a little bit more. Right. Here as you step, you want to keep your back, the body stays out there, it stays out there, it stays out there, it stays out there. It's a little bit of a joke. Now she goes the other way, right? So while the legs and arms change, the upper body doesn't. And you want to think that it goes together, 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 together. A little, I would say a little freer than what you're doing. Yeah, don't worry about it. Just kick it off balance and go. Do it without music. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, da-da-da-da-da. There you go. Yeah, so it's freer, freer. Uh-huh, nice. Lauren, bum, 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 bum. Excellent. Yes, excellent, very nice. When you came down, you came down. Right, so make sure you turn out. And this is low, and this is head down and up. And this is low, and this is head down and up. Low, bum, 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 yes. And low, right, and then, that's right, that's right. And it's hard to look down. You have to really look down. And then you want to close the last one, close your fifth. And then your back foot, you're going to roll off that point shoe. That's what it is. All right? Do you want to, what do we have, Gabe?
30.
Okay, 30. Just see if we can catch the devil of pace. You know, why don't you play from the beginning? She'll mark it. It's probably easier. It's better when it's, this is like nothing. It's like a can-can. It's just free. But you have to place your feet, but which you did. Now very free. Arm and leg, arm and leg. Uh-huh. Lauren, nice. Fifth roll down. Passe. Okay. Just remember where we, a little bit before we stopped, Gabe. Excellent, great, very, very, very nice. This was right. You want to finish here. You have to step a little bit more because the step goes this way.
Right, I should try to stay
out. Exactly, so you really want to plie and step out on that one. Right, step out, plie, and passe. That's right, Lauren, that's right. And then the last one, you finish this, so it's a little bit like it's very proper. It's like a, you know, like a real bow, right? Exactly. Then I have to see the pas de cheval. Really, those has to be a jump in the air. Has to be a jump in the air, this way, and then hip, right? And then a jump in the air. Show me those legs and feet, yes, and push off. Uh-huh, and hip, right, exactly. Right, very nice. Let's go from, what do you have, Gabe?
10 seconds more.
Okay, a little bit further back. No, we have to go further back, because that's towards the end. Or just go from the beginning, it's easier. So you want it has to be like almost like a Viennese ball, you know. No, you can keep playing.
That wasn't my variation. No.
but you know, it has to be like a little proper With the arms, right. And show the leg, head up. And now step out, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. Uh-huh. Now show me the hips. And second, passe in the front. Good, okay, good, 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 good. You want to make sure that you passe front, right?
Right.
Susu, passe front, passe front, passe front, passe front, échappé. Susu, passe front, passe. Right, so you really want to stay on that, you have to stay on your supporting hip, on your supporting hip. And then from here, you want to cross. And you want to present, right? Okay, good.
So that was Lauren Fadeley in the fourth variation from Divertimento number 15 with our artistic director, Lourdes Lopez.
We were talking earlier about how George Balanchine was the father of neoclassicism, and we were talking about how this is very classical. But I think what's so cool about that variation is how, he brings some hips forward. He does some jazzy elements to it in a tutu, right?
Right. You get these sort of quirky moments that are also very much from their originator, Tanikeo Leclerc, who I mistakenly said was the last variation. But the turned-in passes and all these like pulling off to show off your long legs. So, Lauren, if you want to come join us now. That was beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. So, this is, Balanchine is very much in your blood. You went to the School of American Ballet, which was his school. So, does it feel like you're at home in a ballet like this?
Yeah, it feels visiting this again. It's been a few years since I've really been back in this house of Balanchine. So, I feel like I still have a lot more to learn, but it's just so musical and so dancey, and it just feels really nice to be doing this again.
So you have done this ballet before. I believe it was at your SAB workshop, is that correct?
Mm-hmm. Yes, a long time ago, I will not say when. When I was at SAB, I did the core of Divertimento for my workshop performance. So this is my first time getting to learn one of the leads, and it's such an honor and just so wonderful to be a part of.
Kind of fun to have those like full circle moments.
Totally. Yeah.
Yeah, but what that variation looks crazy challenging at the end. You have to do those pirouettes at that sort of breakneck speed after you've already done, your whole variation. So what kind of moments do you have to reel it in and think like how what are you thinking of how to get through those challenges?
Well, I think with this variation, there's a lot of playfulness and off balance, but it also has to be very controlled. And I find my body sometimes is a little not all reined in together. So you have those challenging moments where you do have to change your body and things like that, but you still have to have the correct placement to do it as well. So yeah, still working on it.
Looked very reined in to me. I thought it was beautiful. We have one question from Facebook from Claudia. She says, how do you stay up so long in those shoes?
Oh, that's a good question. it gets pretty painful. We do a lot of taping of our toes, lots of years of practice and lots of strength, but it definitely does. It gets very pretty painful. Yeah.
There are a lot of exercises involved in that, right?
Yes.
Okay, well, thanks so much for joining us. And if you want to say...
thank you so much to our dancers, Jordan Elizabeth Long and Lauren Fadeley, to our artistic director, Lourdes Lopez, and to all of you for joining us today. We really hope you enjoyed it as much as we did.
Watch for Miami City Ballet's featured segment during National Day of Canada's live stream coming up at 12:46 p.m. Eastern. To watch the entire stream, go to the National Ballet of Canada's Facebook page at facebook.com/nationalballet. Thanks again, everyone.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Karen, thank you so much for inviting us to be part of World Ballet Day. And of course, it would be my pleasure to tell you a little bit about Miami City Ballet. Miami City Ballet is a family, and most of the company's dancers train at Miami City Ballet School. So therefore, they grow up together, and once they get into the company, they maintain those friendships, as well as build others. The first thing that people notice about Miami City Ballet dancers is their disposition. They're warm, friendly, open, sunny, and they have an energy and a vitality that is very much Miami City Ballet. And so much of this comes from where we live and from where we work in South Florida. Our greatest asset is obviously our repertory, and after New York City Ballet, we are one of the largest repositories of the Balanchine works. And of course, we're known as a Balanchine style company. Along with the Balanchine works, we also do works by Jerome Robbins, Twyla Tharp, Paul Taylor, John Cranko, and Frederick Ashton, and some of the very well-known 19th century classics. Right now we're rehearsing Giselle, which opens our program one. It is a story of a young and innocent peasant girl turned mad by her lover's betrayal, who returns from the dead to save him from death. You have to do this way. You've got to go this way. And into your stomach, right? And so they're out here. It's out here. It's out there. That's what you have to do.
Okay.
Every time.
I was doing this. So
no, forget 20th century. Go back to 19th. Right, and now do it again and really turn this out and bring that heel forward as you step and see what that does to you. And keep the heel forward. See what it does to you?
Yeah.
Ballet. It was good, Jordan. Very good. We have also commissioned works by Twyla Tharp, Liam Scarlett, and Justin Peck. And right now in our studios, we have Alexei Ratmansky with our second commission from him, The Fairy's Kiss.
So the port de bras is to the left, open to the right, turn. New phrase comes. Both of us go plié, ballonne there, right? Then ladies continue into the pique, écarté, foot attitude. Up. Press.
I got it.
Are you afraid of the heights?
No, just up that lift.
Okay, and then just do that. Without changing your weight.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anything you do, just don't change the weight. Okay. It will start with you going susu, and then da da da. Thank you. Yeah, thanks. Maybe just a little tender flesh.
Another great feature that distinguishes Miami City Ballet is that many of our dancers are from Latin and South America. Miami City Ballet and Miami City Ballet School have the largest number of dancers from the Global South, and we are fast becoming one of the training grounds for the dancers from this region. We send talent scouts to countries such as Brazil, Mexico, and Colombia, and give full scholarships for students to study and train with us. This diversity is what gives the company and school its distinct look, its physicality, and its musicality on stage. And we are proud to have four cities that we call home: Miami, Palm Beach, Naples, and Fort Lauderdale. On behalf of Miami City Ballet and Miami City Ballet School, we would like to thank Artistic Director Karen Kane and everyone at the National Ballet of Canada for inviting Miami City Ballet to be part of World Ballet Day.